So all you have to do is hit one button, one skin smoothing, turn it on, and just wait. Wait for this thing here in the corner to finish spinning. And voila. So this is actually pretty impressive. Look at the before and after. Before and after. All I did was to click one button. Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. So Adobe Photoshop 2021 has some new features, and prominent among these we have the skin retouch and the sky replacement. So today we're going to take a quick look at the skin retouch. I just played around with it for a little bit and I am quite impressed. You know, it could do some of the heavy lifting. If you, let's say I have to deliver 250 pictures tomorrow and for some reason I cannot spend 1 hour dodging and burning every single picture, this could do some of the lifting because you can actually separate the texture from the tonal smoothing, and you don't have to use all of them. You can just use it to make your life just a little bit easier. All right, so stay with me right here and I will show you how to use this feature real quick. So I have this image in Lightroom, and this is the original image. And here I am going to, I just cropped it here. I'm going to show you exactly what I did here. I just cropped it and I cooled it down a little bit, and all the changes I made right here, all these sliders in Lightroom, just so the color is not too bad as we take it to Photoshop. So I'm going to take this to Photoshop and test out the skin smoothing on it. Now, just a little close up so you can actually see what we're working with. She has pretty good skin, but there's definitely some imperfections. I haven't done any spot removal. You know, you can do a quick click spot removals here to make it even better, but I'm not going to do any spot removal just to put this to the real test. Okay, so now that we have this image, we're going to go straight into Photoshop. Edit in Photoshop. Make sure it's 2021. If it's the old one, you're not going to have that feature. Make sure you have Adobe Photoshop 2021. Okay. All right, so now we are in Photoshop. Now, usually you would want to create a background duplicate and make your edits on there. But from what I've read, the skin retouch creates a new layer. So we're going to go straight and test it out. Don't do anything. When you come right in here, all you have to do is go to Filter and Neural Filters. Neural Filters, what a name. Well, let's hope it does what it says it does. Okay, so now that we are in here, we want to zoom in just so we see what's happening on the face, and we want to see how smart this thing is. Okay, so now that you zoomed in, just note that when you are editing any picture, when you zoom all the way in, make sure you zoom out from time to time to see how much damage you've done or how it actually looks, because when you are all the way in, you can overdo it most of the time. Okay, all right, so all you have to do is hit one button, one skin smoothing, turn it on, and just wait for this thing here in the corner to finish spinning, and voila. So this is actually pretty impressive. Look at the before and after. Before and after. All I did was to click one button. I mean, if someone had a gun to my head and asked me to deliver 200 images in an hour, I guess this is what I'll be using. All right, so let's actually get into detail. So all I did was, turn on skin smoothing, and once I turned it on, these sliders were in the middle here, and the image went from what we have right now to this. I did nothing else. I just turned on the button. I just turned it on. That's all. Now, these two sliders here are quite important. We have the blur and the smoothness, okay? All right, so these two sliders, the blur and the smoothness, are quite related to frequency separation. The top blur here actually works more like your texture layer. It controls how much of the texture is retained, all the little pimples and pores and everything. It's like how much of it is retained. And the smoothness layer here is more like your tonal or color layer. So it actually merges your color. So let me show you that first. I'm going to move the smoothness all the way back here. And I want you to keep an eye on the color of the cheek. You see this side of her cheek, her right cheek, my left side. Yeah. And then look at the color here. Look at the color right up here. There's quite a difference because, I mean, the blush, I think they actually apply a different color for the blush. But when you are editing or even doing makeup, there is the blending brush that you want to have a smooth transition between one color and the next. And that creates the illusion of a smooth surface. So look at this right here. I'm going to pull this all the way forward. And voila, you can see that the color here is closer to the color here, but it has a smoother transition instead of what it had before. Like when I pull it all the way back, you will see that the color before was intense. So this is the color stuff. That's it. So even if you don't want to use the blur feature on here, you can bring your blur all the way down to zero, and then you can do the color stuff depending on the image you have, and this will actually not mess with your skin texture or anything. You can actually go back and use frequency separation or dodge and burn ever so slightly to fix the skin texture and not have to worry about the color blending, because this color blending is what you get from not exactly, but close to what you get when you use the mixer brush and stuff like that. So this, I mean, you can be very liberal with this one. You can pull it pretty much pretty high, and it doesn't do a lot of damage to the picture from what I see. And the blur, you kind of want to start from the back and move your way forward because you don't want the skin texture to blur out too much. So I'm gonna bring this back quite a bit. Yeah, something like that. Now, remember what I said from the beginning, you have to zoom out to see. So click the zoom button over here and hold Z and click and drag to the left. And then you zoom out and then you see what damage you're actually causing to this image. Well, it looks quite smooth to me. I don't like that, especially for an outdoor portrait. So I'm going to pull this back a little bit more. Less blur is good. And maybe the smoothness back a bit. Let's see the before and after. Before and after. Before and after. Let me zoom in again so you guys can see one more time before we hit OK. Here is the before and here is the after. Okay. So I'm going to zoom out and I'm going to pretend I am okay with this image and hit okay and see what happens. So this creates a new layer with only the adjustments that it made. So I'm going to close the background layer so you see what it did. So this is the new layer it created with the adjustments that it made. Now, with this new layer, I'm going to add a mask onto this layer so that I can control some stuff, okay? And I'm going to show you this in put a mask on there, select a brush, right click brush tool, and then switch the color from white to black and just zoom in. And here's what I want you to understand. It's like, all these changes, you don't want some of these smoothing changes to affect certain areas like the eye. You want to have full control over the eye. So pretty much everything inside the eye I am going to black out. I don't want the effect to be there. And so I'm going to do this even right up to here. I'm going to black those out. Okay. I'm going to do the same for this one too. And I should probably be showing you what exactly is happening. I'll show you in a second. Okay. All right, let's make the background visible. So what I'm actually doing is, you see these two nostrils, right? If I remove this side, you see what happened? This side is more realistic now. The color hasn't blended. It's still not smart enough to know that inside the nostril has to have a shadow. So it's kind of like blending the color in there. So in here, I'm going to remove this one too. And you can see that it's more realistic. Yeah. I think I did a little too much. So I'm going to Control Z. I'm going to make the brush smaller just so I can get it there. Yeah, something like that. All right. So, but I think it's easier because I understand what I'm trying to get rid of. It's easier for me to do this with the background turned off. So now that the background is turned off, everything that you don't want smoothened, you don't want to see here. So I don't want the edges of the eyes to be smoothened, right? So I am brushing them out, okay? I don't want the edges of the lips here to be smoothened or messed with. So I am brushing those out. Okay. All right. So now that I've brushed those out, and then right outside here looks like it could be the hair. So I'm just gonna brush it out a little bit. Okay. All right. So I think this is good enough. And voila. So this is just the extra stuff you can do to make sure it doesn't smoothen your eyes and your nose and your lips and stuff. And that's pretty much it. I think it's actually quite impressive. And from here, you can go and apply global dodge and burn and makes the cheekbones pop and all the other stuff that you know. But all this could be done in a few seconds. It's ridiculous. All right. So for the next video, I'm going to compare the sky replacement of Photoshop and Luminar. I've already seen a difference and I'm going to point that out in the next video. So do well to subscribe and the next video should be out in about 2 days. All right. Thank you for watching and peace.